Mix 94.7 KMCH. We are about to embark on a journey, you and I. For the next week, we're going to find out which couple in the KMCH listening area knows each other the best. And that winning couple on Friday, the one with the most points, is going to get a an amazing prize pack, including John Swisher's 2014 Chevy Impala. He doesn't know that yet. But welcome in couple number one, Larry and Teresa Tippett. How are you guys this morning?
Wonderful.
Larry, would you describe kindly, you wanted to make sure we got the mug on the video stream.
Oh, it's just American Legion, Post 45.
Thank you for your service, sir. Yeah,
thank you.
Now, how did you meet this lovely woman sitting next to you?
Oh, that's not one of the questions.
No, I mean, this is just a little get to know each other, break the ice sort of portion before we get down to it here.
So. We were on the fire department in Delaware.
Okay.
That's where we first met.
Gotcha. Was Teresa? Was it love at first sight?
No.
Nope. Not one bit actually. No. So, all right. Now, if you watch the old Bob Eubanks Newlywed game, right?
Yep.
So the question is for you. I can't ask any more questions because now we have to separate you.
All right.
Have you decided who is going to slip out of the room and who's going to stay in and answer the questions?
I'm going to answer the questions first,
yeah,
I guess.
I'm okay. Going to exit stage right.
All right. So then, Teresa, we will dismiss you. You follow Danny into the production room. We're going to let you walk out, and you're going to be able to watch us, but you're not good at reading lips, are you, right, Teresa? Okay, good. All right, good enough. All right, so we dismiss her. All right. Larry, I have hand-selected five questions. Now, these are different questions. No couple will ever get the same questions that I'm about to ask you. I'm going to ask you to write your answers on this piece of paper here.
If you can read it.
Yep. Well, I've got bad handwriting, too. So, all right. Now, the goal of the game here is you want to match what you think Teresa is going to match, because we'll ask her the same questions here. So, question number one. Who would you say is the better catch? What would she say? Would she say she's the better catch, or would she say you're the better catch? Remember, you're the one that wants to match. The goal here is to get a match.
She's the better catch.
Okay, well, then you go ahead and write her down, and then we'll put it face down. So, right in. And how many years did you guys, or how long did you date before you guys were married?
2 years.
2 years, okay. 2 years. Gotcha. Was it a big fire? Was it a small fire? Was it on a call, or just happened to be in a meeting when you guys met?
Well, we worked together at the fire department.
Okay.
Didn't really hang out much together.
Mm-hmm.
She was always busy. You know, she was up here at the hospital. Nurse. Mm-hmm. She'd show up for the first part of the meetings for the first responders, and then it was get in, get out. Mm-hmm. She had her daughter to take care of.
So, okay.
So we didn't chat much.
Gotcha. And now here, and how long have you guys been together now?
9 years.
Holy cow. You might be one of our second longest couples doing this
married,
week, too.
Married 9 years, yeah.
Wow. All right, question number two for you. Now, again, you want a match. Have you ever given your spouse a gift you know they didn't like but never said anything about it? Did one of you give each other a gift that the other one knows this was a swing and a miss, but were too nice to say anything about it?
Has she, or either one of us?
Either one of us. Again, you want a match. So what comes to your mind, what you think, that you guys would match on? There was ever a gift given to one of you, whether she gave it to you or you gave it to her, you're like, oh, that's nice, you know, but never complained about it or anything. Oh, it's a tricky one.
That's a tricky one. That might be for questions later on. Like,
that might be a discussion starter.
Which,
you know?
One was it? Yeah, I say there probably has been.
Okay. So what are you writing down?
Yes.
Well, you get a little bit deeper, a little bit more specific. Is there something that comes to mind?
Oh, not that I can.
Okay, we'll just go with yes. If we match on a yes, it's points. Yeah, so
I'm going to say everything that she's given me, I've appreciated. So
okay, so she'll be the one that comes up with something.
She
like,
might.
He got me a pair of socks our second anniversary, and I didn't say anything, but it was the worst.
Change that question. Can I change that to?
You can cross it out and change whatever you want. Yeah.
I'm gonna say no. I know she'll appreciate it.
Okay. So you're gonna write no. Okay. Yeah. Gotcha. All right. Question number three, Mr. Larry Tippett. Where was your first kiss?
Yeah.
I'm talking like geographically on a map, not on, you know, it's not that kind of show.
That's what we told each other. Keep it clean.
Exactly. Thank you. I'm assuming Danny read you the riot and you all read a Bible verse before you came here just to be safe. All right, and you're writing
under the street light.
Okay. All right, tell me that story. Where, what town?
In Delaware.
Okay.
One of the first.
Well, the nice thing about Delaware, there's only one street light, so it's very
pretty much. Yeah. It was just a night. I think it was probably the first night that we really met each other.
Okay.
That, you know, we was out and we just.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Question number four. What was your worst date? Worst date you two were ever on? Anything come to mind?
Boy, that's a tough one.
Or like a restaurant where somebody got sick or flat tire on the way or something like that. Somebody had a drink spilled on them, something like that.
Okay. I can't remember the name of the restaurant. I know.
Maybe it's better we don't remember the name of the restaurant.
Well, yeah. what was the name of that restaurant? She might remember the name of the restaurant, okay. But it was the food was not good.
You could just write bad food, and then maybe that'll spark the memory there. And then final question, one thing that Teresa owns that you want to throw away. She's got one thing, you can't stand it, you want to get rid of it at all costs. What is that thing? Like an old ratty sweater or a hoodie or, you know, an obnoxious tchotchke or like an air freshener or something like that. One thing that Teresa owns that you want to throw away.
Well, a lot of her friends probably know about it. It's her hairspray.
Okay. Got it. Okay.
She has been known to apply a lot of hairspray.
Remember, these are your words, not mine.
Right.
I just want to point that out. All right. So what we're going to do, we're going to take a little pause here. When we come back, we're going to see if Larry and Teresa can match each other. We'll take a quick pause and continue on with the newlywed game right after this on Mix 94.7 KMCH.
The KCRG TV9 First Alert forecast for your Monday. Our sky does turn partly cloudy. Overall, not a bad early February day. We're looking at highs here in the low to mid 20s. Partly cloudy, rising temperatures later on tonight. Tomorrow, turning partly cloudy again. It still looks like the bright spot of the week here as highs hit the lower 40s. There's a chance of a snow shower on Wednesday. Cooler and windy there with highs in the mid to upper 30s. That's your latest TV9 First Alert forecast. I'm meteorologist Kai O'Mara on Mix 94.7 KMCH.
Check out this doorbuster special, available only at your Manchester Dollar Fresh. Today only, you can pick up a 5-pound bag of one-step russet potatoes for just 99 cents. That's right, just 99 cents, the best price in town. Take advantage of this crazy low price today only. This doorbuster is only today, while supplies last, and only at your Manchester Dollar Fresh.
Are you looking to build a new home and in search of a reliable contractor you can count on? Let S&R Construction make the dreams of your forever home a reality.
From the start, Steve at S&R Construction was honest. He communicated well with us, and he was very flexible. We wanted to work with some of the contractors in the Coggin area, and we were able to do that. We're confident he would do what he said, and he always followed through. He set high expectations for his crew and the contractors he worked with, and he was kind, but yet firm when it came to dealing with other people. S&R Construction delivers high-quality work, and they stick to their timelines. The best part is that Steve became a family friend during the building process.
Call Steve Petlin at S&R Construction today at 319-361-0638 and make the dreams of your forever home a reality.
Community Savings Bank is proud to present a free seminar on estate transition planning with guest speaker Melissa O'Rourke on Friday, February 25th from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Melissa O'Rourke is a farm and agribusiness management specialist for ISU Extension and Outreach. She is also an attorney with experience within the estate transition area. Multiple topics will be covered during the seminar, ranging from wills and trusts, property ownership, coordinating plans, family conversations, communication, estate, inheritance, and gift taxes. The seminar will be held at the Edgewood Event Center in Edgewood from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. A plated lunch will be provided to all attendees free of cost. The seminar is open and free to all. Registration is required for the event by February 8th. To register, call CSB at 1-800-828-2318. Community Savings Bank is a locally owned and operated community bank with locations in Cedar Rapids, Coggin, Dyersville, Earlville, Edgewood, Gardevillo, Guttenberg, Manchester, Marion, and Robbins. Member FDIC.
At Three Rivers FS, we understand that crop nutrition is vital to crop performance. Every farm, every field, and every acre is different. Our crop specialists are driven to maximize every acre and bring the latest agronomic technologies and innovations to your farm. Contact your local Three Rivers FS today to talk to a crop specialist or visit threeriversfs.com.
We are in the midst of the newlywed game, day number one. Larry and Teresa Tibbett with us. Teresa, what were they playing in the hyperbaric chamber next door?
Disco Inferno.
Was that a request or was that punishment?
It was the longest song they had in the sound.
Really? I'm so sorry.
They didn't play Alice's Restaurant?
No, I don't even know if we have that yet, but we will at some point. By Thanksgiving time, we'll have that.
Longest song.
All right. So Larry did a good job. I told him, you know, no matter what we do here, you want to make sure you match Teresa, whatever you think she's going to say. Okay. So he's written down his answers. I'm going to ask you the same questions. Question number one, which one of you would say who's the better catch? Is it you or is it Larry? Who's
That's
the better catch?
Hard one.
Yeah, we started with a hard one.
Keep it clean.
Yes. Remember, family show, family station.
Say me.
All right. So Teresa's a better catch. So there's 5 points right there. We go. So I should probably get my scorecard out here. So all right. So 5 points so far. Question number two, Teresa, is have you ever given Larry or has Larry ever given you a gift that you know he didn't like or he knows that you didn't like, but you didn't say anything about it?
Oh, that's a hard one.
Yeah. I think I overthought it when I put these questions together. Did you ever give him a gift or he ever give you a gift that you know he didn't like or he knows you didn't, but you didn't say anything about it? Like, anything come to mind?
That is a really hard question.
Wait till we get to question five.
Yeah.
Do I have a time buzzer that's going to go off here pretty soon?
We're on the air till six tonight. We got plenty of time. So we'll just eat into Janelle's time. It's fine. So.
Candy.
Candy?
I don't know.
She says candy. Larry? Larry, what do you got?
I just said no.
He said no. He said you'd be gracious and happy no matter what. So,
yeah.
So, yeah.
That's all right. We still got a few to go yet. So question number three, where was your first kiss, Teresa? And again, location geographically, not at, you know.
Keep it clean.
Yes. Again, keep it clean.
Under
kids listening.
Under a street light.
Under a street light, Larry said, under a street light. Tell me about it. Now, there's only like one or two street lights in Delaware. Was it hot out? Was it cold out? Was it summertime, nighttime? When was it?
It was cold out.
It's cold out. Okay.
It was March. It was cold.
So there's 5 points right there. All right. Question number four. Tell me about your worst date.
Oh.
Worst date. Like, was it a flat tire or somebody got a drink spilled on them or bad food or food poisoning or?
Honestly, I don't think we've had a bad date per se that I can recall. I'm going to say, I mean, there hasn't been a bad date.
Okay.
And that's my answer.
Larry says?
Had a bad Italian food.
Bad Italian food. Now that he said that, do you remember now what he's talking about?
It was dishwater noodles.
Yep. So not a match there, unfortunately. All right.
No.
Question five. This is the 30-point question. So our first 4 or 5 points, question five is the big makeup question. What's one thing that your spouse owns that you want to throw away? Is there something that Larry owns you want to throw away? Or is there something that you own that Larry wants to throw away?
Well, I think I already threw it away. It was a hall tree that he had.
Oh, I forgot about that. She hates hall trees.
Hall trees? Aw.
Oh,
well, wait till you see what he wrote down.
Your hairspray.
Hairspray. Oh, man.
I said, all your friends would be very well. They would know.
Yeah, yes. You could hear them laughing as he said that. I can hear it.
It's the 80s. Still lives in.
Well, tell you what. You guys are couple number one. Everybody wins a little something, you know, just for being brave and being with us on the radio. So I got a gift certificate to you from the market in Edgewood. We also have a $25 gift certificate to Brew and Brew in Dyersville and a koozie and all kinds of stuff. And our thanks for joining us as couple number one on the Newlywed Game. Teresa, I'm going to hand this off to you. And over 9 years together now.
Yeah. 9 years, yep. So, 9 years married.
9 years married. How many years together?
12. It will be 12.
Will be 12.
And I'm assuming Valentine's night can go dishwater noodles at a restaurant somewhere.
No.
Yeah, I know.
Well, thank you guys for coming and being good sports, and we'll see how you guys stack up. We have four more couples to go, and the one with the most points will be our grand prize winner. But thanks so much for helping us kick it off this week, guys.
All right.
All right. Larry and Teresa Tibbett, give them the big round of applause that they deserve. We will roll on with more Newlywed Game tomorrow just after 9:30 right here on Mix 94.7 KMCH.
GNB Bank is proud to be a local and employee-owned community bank with a focus on friendly, personal service from people you know and trust. GNB Bank takes care of the communities they serve by offering a variety of financial solutions, loans, real estate, trust services, insurance, investments, to basics like checking and savings. They're committed to being your financial partner. GNB Bank, expanding your financial horizons. Visit gnbbank.com for more information and to find a location most convenient for you. GNB Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Get everything you need for your Valentine this week at Bushel and a Peck, Texas Jumbo